Hey everybody, it is, what is it, Tuesday, Thursday? Yes, Thursday the 9th at exactly 11:41 p.m. In 19 minutes, it will be officially, well technically 20 minutes, it'll officially be the 10th and my birthday. So I thought I would make a quick video, not so that I can have people acknowledge it's my birthday. I appreciate all the birthday greetings I've gotten so far, thank you everybody. But like most holidays or days of celebration in my life, they're either associated with bad memories or, well, no, with bad memories. You know, growing up poor, there's two paths that can happen here. Growing up poor, you either learn to appreciate the holidays more because they have more value and more meaning to you, or learn to hate the holidays because it's a disappointment. You know, it's a regular disappointment of knowing that once again another day that's supposed to be special for whatever reason isn't. And I have to say that I went obviously the latter of those two. You know, I've had a lot of Christmases and birthdays and other days of celebration be pretty negative in terms of disappointment or letdown or what have you. You know, I mean, when you don't have any money, you don't get to celebrate as well. And my birthday is actually one of, like, now four. Before it was me and my brother because we were born 4 days apart. 3 years apart. He's 3 years older than me. But we're born 4 days apart, so I never had my own birthday. It was always my brother and my birthday. We would share, because when you're poor, that's what you do. You know, you have one cake, celebrate two things. And I'm not complaining too much about that, because you know that was how I understood life to be. But I'm just giving that as a context of why I don't really celebrate my birthday, why I don't really do much. It's just another day of the week to me. It's gotten to that point where there's really no purpose to celebrating my birthday. And this really isn't going the direction I was hoping it would. You know, I wanted to make a video and just say thank you to all the nice people out there that have said happy birthday to me, and all the people that are going to say happy birthday, thank you very much, I appreciate it. No luck on the job front still. I put in an application for several positions at a Best Buy around the corner for the Geek Squad, because I went onto their site and it said that they were looking for people. As well as a front desk or a cashier. And I'm like, look, just pay me so I can pay rent. I'll be a cashier 8 hours a day. I don't care, you know. Here's the irony of that situation. Okay, so I submitted my resume, and then I've had problems with this Best Buy before where I've called them and nobody picks up the phone. Like, and that's not, I'm not exaggerating the statement there. Literally, I call them. And you go through the phone dial, press 1 if you want to know our location, press 2 for store times, press 3 to talk to somebody, and you press 3. If you want to speak to a customer service representative, press 1. If you want to speak to a Geek Squad representative, press 2. So I press 1, and the phone rings 25 times, and it goes back to the voicemail option. And I press 1 again, it rings another 25 or 30 times, and goes back to the voicemail option. And I press it again, and it rings another 25 or 30 times, and then it hangs up on me because nobody's there. And then I call back. And this time I try to call Geek Squad, and the Geek Squad doesn't pick up. Yesterday, I think it was yesterday, I called them because I wanted to follow up on my job application, and I literally called them 3 times and went through that cycle. So finally I got frustrated and fed up and called the district office, the corporate office, and wanted to lodge a complaint as well as find out what I needed to do to follow up on my resume. And I spoke to the lady, and you know, I told her, I said, look, I have two main concerns. The first being that I wanted to follow up on my resume. Who do I need to speak to? And she said, oh, well, you need to talk to the people at the store that you applied to. And I said, well, that's the reason why I'm calling for number 2, because I tried and nobody's answering the damn phone. So when I got transferred from that, they hung up on me, the corporate office. So I called back, and when I called back, apparently the office, the customer satisfaction line or something, that department was closed after being on hold for like 5 minutes and then having them hang up. And so I called back again and again, and finally I got through to somebody in the tech squad, at the store, and I asked to speak to a manager, and they put me on hold, and then they hung up on me. So I called back again, and got through to somebody and said I wanted to speak to a manager, and he said, well, why? And I said, because I've been calling your store for the last 20 minutes, and apparently nobody answered it. Here's the thing about this, is that I called before. This happened like a month ago, and I called them before and had the same problem. I went into the store and talked to one of the managers there and said, look, I called and the phone rang and nobody picked it up, and I walked in. You're not that busy. Is there a reason why you people don't pick up the phone? And she said, oh, well, you know, they're supposed to do this and this, but there's no excuse, and it doesn't always happen, and I'm sorry you had this experience, yada, yada, yada. And I said, whatever. So, obviously, calling the store that I want to apply to and complaining about their customer service is not the best way to go about getting a job, so I'm going to stop by there tomorrow, physically walk in, and see if the manager's there and talk to them about it. But, once again, it doesn't look like this is a very promising job opportunity. I'm coming to the end of my first unemployment extension. You get 3 in California. And I've already gone through the main, and I'm coming, literally, my next check will be the last check I can get for my first extension, and then possibly get my second. And I can't count on the government to do what they're supposed to do. You know, otherwise that'll give me another 2 or 3 months to continue to look for work. But up to this point, I'm not having any success, and I'm frustrated. Because, you know, I like where I live. I said this before. And, you know, this is sort of contradictory to the last video that I posted where I talked about just recognizing what you have and being grateful. And I'd like to just say for the record that I'm grateful for what I have right now. And it's hard not to look at the things that I don't have because the things that I don't have are stability. You know, it's not like I don't have a new car, I don't have a bigger TV, I don't have nicer clothes. What I don't have is the ability to know that next week my rent's going to be paid. And for somebody like me, where stability is paramount, that's a hard thing to not look at and be frustrated with. I understand that the next step would be just to move into the camper, which is this like weird 1970s pickup truck modification thing. It's a good little thing, but you know, living in that's not going to be pleasant. It'll be out front of my mom's house, so I'll have internet access, and she'll run a power cord out to the car. But it would be like living in a walk-in closet is basically what it's going to be like. And I have to go into the house when I need to use the bathroom and use a shower or whatever. So it's not exactly a preferable situation, but it's better than sleeping outside. And believe me, sleeping on the streets is a very scary experience. So, yeah, coming up on my 36th birthday. Going to be 4 years short of 40. And I've said this many times in my life, that I spent my entire childhood wanting to grow up so I can get away from the pains of childhood. And finally, when I did grow up, I never had a childhood. So it was like both sides of that particular coin are a bit tarnished. You know, looking back, oh, it was, things were better then, but no, they weren't. You know, you lose the distinct edge of the painful stuff that you dealt with as a kid because you've been moved, you know, you've been separated from it, you know. Absence makes the heart grow fonder and all that crap. But I remember that I was an unhappy kid, and now here I am in an adult situation, and I'm faced with realities that I have to deal with, you know. And like I say, being unemployed can be a real soul crusher. It makes you doubt your value. I mean, I know that there are things that I can do, but I've gotten to the point where I don't know if I can do them anymore. I don't know if I have any value whatsoever. So it's tough. It's really tough. And that's pretty much all that's going on with me, man. I don't really have any stories to tell or things to say. The model for the castle, the ramparts thing is done. We just need to do some modifications to it because it didn't glue together very well. And then there's some painting that needs to be done for the model to give it more of a military building look, you know, instead of just being that army green. That it ended up being, we gotta sort of give it a more stone-faced look. And my roommate Steve got his Space Wolves army together finally, and he's now going through the models that he got off of eBay that a friend of his bought because his friend lost his original army, so he's replacing them. But he's got a lot of models, and they're badly painted or badly put together. The guy that sold the army had no idea what the hell he was doing when he put them together. So Steve's got to go through that. And, yeah, so that's pretty much it, folks. That's all that's going on with my life. I wish I had more to say. I wish I had more positive stuff to say. But right now, I'm still in. I'm still able to post this on the internet. I'm still breathing. And I'm still alive. And that's something. So to all you people out there, I hope that you will celebrate my birthday by celebrating your own. And what I mean by that is, take my birthday as an excuse to celebrate your life and get together with friends and family and just have a wonderful day tomorrow. It's Friday. It's the beginning of the weekend. Please, please, if you can do anything for my birthday, I would ask that you just enjoy yourselves and celebrate life for at least one day. And, you know, get together with people that you love and people that you care about and people that celebrate you and show you how special you are. And just let that be your birthday present to me. It's just being reminded that you're all wonderful people and you deserve to have that recognition. And that'll make me happy, knowing that you guys and gals out there are recognizing your own value and your own worth and finding some happiness in this crazy world. Alright, so until whenever I get around to posting my shit again, I will. Until then.